Hi, in this video we're going to share how you create an app with AppMachine. Now press the red building block to create a new app and fill in the name, for instance, Marcus. Now fill in the URL of your website and hit the scan button. So we'll now start scanning your website. We will look for interesting links like images, your Facebook account, Twitter account, YouTube videos that you might have on your website, as well as RSS feeds. AppMachine will use this information to customize your building blocks and have them ready for use in your app. It is also possible to stop the process. Your app is now being put together. Alright, we have found the following Facebook accounts and we will select this one. We'll do the same for Twitter and select the most relevant account. So up next are the news feeds we found. Let's select two feeds to use in our app. Okay, here we go. After the content part, we are now going to select a design or a skin to apply to the app. A skin consists of a navigation style, a color scheme, backgrounds, and button styles, all for you to use in your app. With a skin, you can instantly make your app look gorgeous. Later on, you will be able to further style your app, just the way you like it. Congratulations! Your app is now ready to use. On the left side of your screen, you can see the different stages of building your app. Now let's start on the Build tab. Here you can manage your content and design. Later on, we'll be looking at publishing your app under the Publish tab. And when your app is live, you can track and analyze under the Analyze tab. Okay, now let's go back to the Build tab. On the left side, you see the yellow building blocks that we created previously. In the middle, you see the settings, and on the right, you will have your live view. With live view, you can view your app while building it. You can download it on your mobile by visiting the URL. Now log in with your account details and click the live view button in your app. You can now view your app on your mobile. You now have immediate feedback of the changes you made in your app. You can also choose to have your app running in the browser and support you to easily adjust your app to your desired look and feel. We are now going to take a closer look at the building blocks that we've added while scanning your website. For example, the Twitter building block. We found a Twitter account and you can immediately see how it looks on your phone. If you would zoom in on a tweet, you see that you have a fully functional Twitter client, and that actually enables you to reply, retweet, and favorite right from within your app. Now, if you want to see how your Facebook building block looks like, just click on it and you can see the account details, and in your live view you can see how it looks. Facebook also includes likes and comments, and it's fully functional. And here you see the RSS feeds. It's a submenu that contains two feeds that we added previously, and as we click one, you'll see the URL that we retrieved from the website. We also see that this feed doesn't contain any images. What we'll do now is hide the images and we'll see the result. There you go. Much better. You can add building blocks over here. We have different building blocks and about 20 plus different ones. So please have a look and select the one that you would need. We're going to add a block and you can experience now how easy and user-friendly we've made it. We're going to add pictures from Facebook. I just fill in the account name. And here we go. If you make a typo somehow, that's okay. We just have a gentle message there. And here you'll see the cover photo of your Facebook account. So we would like to have the albums here. So select these. And now I have the possibility to change the name. There you go. And also change the icon. I will replace this one. We have a set of default icons that you can actually choose from, but we also have the possibility that you can select from the images that we crawled at the beginning, as well as upload, but also search on Google. We're going to do now is a search from Google. Let's see if we find an image that we would like to use. Yes, this one is good. And we can now create a selection out of that image. If the selection is too small, you'll actually get a warning because then the image also will be blurry in the app, and we don't want that. So here we go, we select this one. Good. So now I would like to edit and add some additional effects on the image. I press edit and here we go, effects, And I can select one of the effects that I would like to have. And I think I'll select that one. Good. I'll apply that. So, quite satisfied with the result. And now you have just added a photo block. Congratulations. You can also add another block to group items. We're going to use the submenu building block and we call it social, for example. Now I can drag Facebook and Twitter underneath the submenu of social. So under the blue block, you can see how your home screen looks like. In the settings, you can see the different navigation views. We've created different ones for you to choose from. And you can make it exactly the way you want it to look like. And in the navigation tab, designers have a whole control every pixel in their app. Now let's change the top image on the home screen and make it look more like Marcus. And we'll look for an appropriate image from the crawl we did earlier on. And we'll make a selection from this one here. Oh, that looks good. Let's make a selection and we press save. If we now go to the green block, you can change the design of your whole app. Here you can see the different color settings. You can easily change the color with the color picker. The results are immediately visible in your app. So there you go. Changing the background image is actually a breeze. We'll change it to another one here. There you go. Let's select that one. Yeah, this is how easy it is. Press save and it's done. Now you can make it exactly the way you want to. Designers even have more options to change the look and feel and can change all the buttons and even the style of different buttons, including also the music player. We also created a Photoshop file for you to download and create all the design assets in Photoshop. When you're done with the app, you can go to publish and add the icons and the splash screens, fill all your information for the stores, then click publish to pay for the app, and we will publish your app in the Apple Store and the Google app, Google Play Store. When your app is live, you can track and analyze the usage. Here's a small sample of what we measure, where your users are, the downloads per platform, your most popular content, also which screens are viewed in your app, and how long people are actually in your app. Every item on the analytics dashboard is clickable, and you can quickly drill down into all your stats. On the My Dashboard, you can find all your apps, but also some demo apps for inspiration. Just click one and you can see how the app is built. And there you go on build, and here you can see how it actually is created. If you go on the design tab, you can see how it is made, and here are all the settings. Now for now, I would like to wish you a lot of fun with building your first AppMachine app.